who also joined us last week. So with the practice, maybe they have done the drafting. But before I start, I'd like to introduce myself. So my name is Isi Liasti, as said by Ibu Krisnu Fitriati, and I'm working with Pak Arif Suryo Priatmojo. I hope Pak Arif is also here on the camera.
Yes,
I'm
Bu.
A teacher
yes.
of... Oh, hello, Pak Arif. Pak
yes,
Adam,
Bu.
Please. Show Pak Arif's face to the audience. today we are going, Pak Arif and I will be with you to guide you practicing as a moderator. Of course, you can make the formula of one set of sentences for a moderator, yeah, with combination of different sentences that I have provided you last week. So I hope some of you have made the draft, or maybe some of you are confident enough to just say it without reading the draft, which is very good. Yeah. Okay, so let's check who will volunteer themselves to start practicing as a moderator. We will pretend that there will be a speaker with you know, with a makeup name, so you can make up a name of a professor or a name of you know, a speaker. Yeah, so we use this pretend name as a pretend speaker for today, and you will you'll give introduction and so on by using this pretend biodata. So if you want to volunteer yourself, please raise your hand virtually, and the host will tell us, will tell the moderator who the person is. Please, can anyone raise hand or give comments in the chat box, or you know, raise hand virtually with the facility there provided by Zoom? Okay, there are some.
Okay, for the participant, maybe you can turn on your speaker.
Pak Adam, somebody is asking the material to be shared. So, is it possible that you share the PDF material from the chat box?
Yes, I can, Bu Isi.
Okay, thank you. Would you please do it? So here is the material that we had last week, that basically when we chair a seminar, the first thing we have to say is the opening. The opening is, you know, by saying greeting, by welcoming the audience to the session. And then secondly, we have to mention the objective of the presentation. But this one is optional, so you may just continue with introducing the speaker. And then after introducing the speaker, when you introduce the speaker, you use the biodata of the speaker. Usually, you mention about the position of the speaker, where he works now, what position, like the head of a department or maybe the dean of a faculty. And then you define the time, like you mentioned to the audience, like how much time will be provided for question and answer, and whether the question and answer session will be given the same time or during the presentation or after the presentation. And then, of course, after the presentation, you will have to invite questions from the audience. And then, of course, you have to thank the speaker after the completion of his presentation. And then you invite question, and then you conclude or you thank the speaker and the audience. which are all I gave you last week in the material, and today we are going to practice. Last week I did a lot of talk. I did the, you know, the dominant the dominant speaking. So today I will be doing more listening to you. So I really hope that you do more speaking today. Can anyone practice how to moderate a session, please? Maybe some of you have made or have developed the draft of, you know, of what to say in the seminar. Can someone raise hand? Gak usah malu-malu ya, kita sama-sama belajar di sini. Saya lihat belum ada yang raising hand ya. Yeah, I think in a minute, Pak Adam will send you the material. Oh, okay. Ibu Majidatun Ahmala. Okay, Bu Majid, Bu Mala, would you please practice moderating?
Before that, I'm so sorry. Maybe my English is not better because I am not English department, but I have to try.
Okay. Oh, good. Very good, Ibu. Okay, go on.
I'm not from English department, and I ask you to correct my English.
All right. I will give you feedback. Don't worry.
Thank you.
I will not give you feedback immediately, but maybe later. Yeah. Okay, please just go ahead.
Please correct me. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this session. Our speaker today is Mrs. Umi Hanifa. Is going to her presentation on Arabic learning based on high-order thinking skills, and then giving objectives. As we know that Arabic learning has several types of learning methods, such as grammar translation method, reading method, direct method, or others. But today, we will speak about HOTS, HOTS model, high order thinking skills learning models. And then our objective today is how the implementation of high order thinking skills in Arabic learning. Introduction the speaker. It is great honor for me to introduce our speaker today, Mrs. Umi Hanifa. Mrs. Umi Hanifa is a secretary of language department at Tarbiyah Faculties, Sunan Ampel State Islamic University. She is also editor-in-chief at Al-Fazuna, a journal of Arabic teaching, learning, and linguistics. And then now, I think, defining the time for question. There is will be 15 minutes for question and discussion at the end. Please address the question to the chair, and Mrs. Umi Hanifa will be happy to answer your question. Now, I'd like to invite Mrs. Umi Hanifa to give her presentation. Thank you, Mrs. Umi Hanifa, for an interesting presentation. As I can see, there are three main issues that can be raised in the presentation. First, Bloom Taxonomy proficiency level for critical thinking skills. Second, low order thinking skill, which consists of remember, understand, and apply. High order thinking skills, which consists of analyze, evaluate, and create. Third, the implementation of HOTS, high order thinking skills models in Arabic learning. That will be all for the comments. And now for inviting question. Now it is time for question and discussion, a discussion. If you have any question, Mrs. Umi Hanifa will be happy to answer. Oh, kebalik ternyata. Afwan, maaf. Please raise your hand if you have question. Yes, sir. Please raise your hand and tell your question briefly. Well, ladies, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes this session. And I would like to thank the speaker for the very interesting talk, and also to thank the audience for the participation. And please give the clap to the chatting box. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oh, thank you very much, Ibu Mala. You did very well.
I'm so sorry.
You did very well. Good job. Well, as you requested, you need my feedback, yeah. But I will give feedback later with if you don't mind, Ibu Mala. I will give back later in general with other, you know, other participants common errors, ya. Jadi nanti akan saya beri feedback tentang common errors semua participant di akhir acara supaya nggak terlalu lama Udin nggak terlalu lama menunggu.
Thank you,
Ibu Mala, for a very very responsive participation. Now let's give another chance to another participants. Please, other participants, would you please raise your hand to practice? Jangan malu-malu, ayo biar kita bisa jalan acara praktisnya. I will do more listening. Ya, oke, Ibu. Ya, ini yang ngacungnya tidak virtual, nggak apa-apa. Ibu siapa ya? Can you mention your name ya? Hostnya udah bisa mengidentifikasi belum ini Pak Adam? Pak Edi. Ya, yang Ibu, mana, silahkan. Oke. Okay. Ini udah ada yang mengacung tadi. Silahkan, Ibu.
Hello.
Yes. Yes, please.
Okay, I'm Rahmawati from Chokraminata University.
Okay, Bu Rahmawati.
Okay. I'd like to try how to be a moderator.
Right.
Okay, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to listen to Mr. Hadi to talk about learning process before and after COVID-19. The objective of this session is to discuss how learning process before and after COVID-19. I'm very pleased to introduce our speaker today, Prof. Hadi Reski, PhD. Prof. Hadi Reski, PhD, is the rector of Harvard University and the founder of Labaco Learning Platform.
Terputus-putus ya. Ibu Rahma.
I thought there is bad connection, Bu.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Oh, no connection.
Bad connection.
Hello.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Go ahead, Ibu.
Okay. Well, I will continue with. So, Prof. Hadi, PhD, is the rector of Harvard University and a founder of Labaco Learning Platform. Before that, he was the rector of Indonesia University in 2018. So, Prof. Hadi got his Strata 1 degree in Indonesia University in 2014 and his master from Tokyo University in 2016 and his doctorate from Harvard University in 2018. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there will be 15 minutes for question and discussion at the end of this session later. And now I'd like to invite Prof. Hadi Reski, PhD, to give his talk. Now come to the closing. Thank you, Mr. Hadi Reski, for some interesting ideas. As I can see, there are three main issues that could be raised in this presentation. The first is blah, blah, blah. The second is blah, blah, blah. And finally, blah, blah, blah. That would be all for the comments now. it time for questions and answer. Next, well, ladies and gentlemen, that's the end of this session, and I would like to thank the speaker for a very informative talk. I'd also like to thank to the audiences for their participation. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give applause to the speaker and the audiences. Thank you.
Okay, very good, Ibu Rahma, ya, Ibu Rahmawati. Yes. Very good. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Well done. I'm really happy to hear you speak English very well. Okay, next. clap. Can we listen to another participant? Please raise your hand. Pak Adam and Bu Fitri will identify you. Please, anyone? Anyone to practice? Ibu Ning, Ibu Hardiningsih, would you please?
Jacqueline, from our friends, not from English major.
Okay, Bu Hardiningsih will help me with Pak Arif, giving feedback to others. Okay, let's listen to other participants. Do we have, let's see, who are the participants? Can anyone raise hands or volunteering yourself?
Halo, kembali, Nak.
Please, enggak usah malu-malu. Oh, maybe we'll give the chance to Pak Hasbi. Would you please, Pak Hasbi? Pak Hasbi, okay.
Yeah, the last 3 months is a webinar season.
Okay.
Many people.
Tidur mau kebelewan mau tidur.
Yeah, feel to speak in English, especially for the official forum like a webinar or a conference. Right. So the problem is for most of the beginner, most of to speak is confidence.
All right.
Actually, most of them are able to write or mm-hmm. read, mm-hmm. But to speak orally, that's another thing.
Okay.
So, yeah. that is why, in my mind, this topic is relevant to the issue, the webinar.
All right. Yes. Yeah. Thank you, Pak Hasbi, for the comments. Yeah. Well, actually, the training is, was intentionally done for daily conversation, daily English conversation. But then there was a request to give, to give a focus on giving presentation in a seminar and moderating a seminar for one or two sessions. So here we are. We are having this now to meet the request of some of the participants. But then after we are done with chairing a seminar, and then next week giving presentation, and then after that practicing pretend presentation in a seminar, and then after that we get back with the daily conversation, which is also important. Daily conversation means the casual in the conversation that you might encounter when you attend like international conference. You have to mingle with your fellow participants, you know, and also to expose you with communication, oral communication, because as you said, people in Indonesia are not confident to speak because we lacked exposure. Because in Indonesia, we don't have partners to speak. We don't have enough exposure to expose us with English. So this training is actually not a formal, not really a formal training, but this is a forum for us to use our English orally, actually. So then you will be fluent in speaking English. So that is, I think, the prime purpose of this training. Thank you very much, Pak Hasbi, for the appreciation. You mentioned that this topic is relevant, and I agree. And that is because of the request of some of the people. Thank you, Pak Hasbi. Would you like to try the moderating? Or
my accent is... my Sulawesi accent is so strong.
I also have strong accent. I'm from Tegal, Pak Hasbi, so don't worry. Because now with the global village, with the world as the global village, with the globalization, I think there is no border between one and other countries. So any Englishes are welcomed. Singaporean English is okay, Malaysian English is okay, and why not Indonesian English? And why not Makassar English? Why not Tegal English? You know, the idea is intelligibility. As long as your English is intelligible or easily understood by people from other countries, then it's okay. That is the purpose of any training of English now. To make you able to speak intelligibly, not necessarily to speak like a native English speaker. So who are the native English speaker? Are they Canadian? Are they Australian? Are they British, you know, English people, or are they American? So, you know, now everyone can speak English in whatever dialect they have. Yeah. Thank you, Pak Hasbi.
Yeah. Yes. Before I joining this meeting, I was in conference. I was in a webinar, and
all right.
some of the foreigners, like from Qatar, from
all right.
yeah, from India, and some other countries, and the dialects is quite variative, and that's good for our listening.
I agree, Pak Hasbi. It gives you more ear training. Your ear will be more familiar with variety of different dialects from different countries. Thank you for the comments and for the feedback and ideas to others, Pak Hasbi. Next, please, other participant maybe want to give comment or practice moderating a seminar.
There is Bu Nur Zaida, Bu.
Oh, Bu Nur Zaida. Okay, Bu Nur, would you please act as a moderator or maybe give comment? Please do.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please do.
Okay, but because I didn't join at first. So what? So glad to meet you here, Bu Isi and Pak Arif and all my friends. I didn't join last week meeting, so
right.
Probably if you don't mind, I'm going to skip some parts because
okay,
I'm not really to prepare. So
All right.
Make a quick draft when you.
Okay.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, I'm please do.
Okay, so good morning. Good morning. Good afternoon. Welcome to this session. And our speaker today is Professor Dr. Arif Yulianto. He is going to give his presentation on teacher support towards the students' autonomous learner. And then the objective of these sessions are first to find out the appropriate scheme for autonomous learner for the students at present. And the second is to provide the teachers with the ideas of the best platform used to support the students autonomous learner. And then it is a great honor for me to introduce our speaker today, Professor Dr. Arif Yulianto. And I'm going to skip this part, and I'm going to jump to the eight because I'm already. And then, moment please, ma'am. So I'm going to go to defining the time for the questions.
Yeah.
There will be time for questions after the presentation, and you have to wait until Professor Dr. Arif Yulianto finish the speech, and then after that there will be 15 minutes for questions and discussion at the end. And then please address the questions to the chair, and I believe that Professor Dr. Arif Yulianto will be happy to answer your questions. And then now I'd like to invite Mr. Arif Yulianto to give the talk. Mr. Arif Yulianto, the floor is yours. And then after the professor giving talk, and then I'm going to thank to the speaker. Thank you, Mr. Arif Yulianto, for very interesting ideas. And then as I can see, there are many issues that can be raised in the presentation. The first is that being an autonomous learner is one of the qualities that should be owned by a student at the moment, especially at this difficult time. And then the second is that there are many platforms provided by the providers that should be explored by the teacher, so they will be able to provide the students with the appropriate platform and to encourage them to be the autonomous learners. Now it's time for questions and discussions. If you have any questions, Mr. Arif Yulianto will be happy to answer. Please raise your hand if you have questions. We will start from the left of the room, okay? And yes, madam, on the left, please give your questions briefly. And after the questions and answer session. So, well, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes this session. And I would like to thank to the speakers for a very informative and interesting talk. And I'd like also to thank to the audience for very active participation in this session. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ibu Nur Zahida. That was great. Thank you. I'm really glad to hear a lot of English today, a lot of great English. Okay, please give applause to Ibu Nur Zahida. Clap, clap, clap.
Thank you.
Okay. The next, please. Anyone would volunteer to act as a moderator or a chairperson in a seminar or conference, please? What do you think, while waiting for someone to raise hand, Ibu Nur Zahida, I really need to ask Ibu Nur Zahida and then Ibu Rahmawati and then Ibu Mala, the three volunteers, what do you think of the materials that I gave you? Was it help you a bit, or was it useful, or do you think I should give you more, or what?
So I think this is useful for us.
Okay, Ibu Rahmati said it was useful. Thank you, Ibu. Ibu Nur Zaida, what do you think?
Ibu Mutmainah, I'm sorry, Provisi.
Okay, Ibu Mutmainah, I saw a hand raised here. Ibu Mutmainah Nursidin. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please. Are you going to volunteer yourself to act as a moderator?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's listen to Ibu Mutmainah.
Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this session. We are going to listen Mr. Najamuddin to talk about blah, blah, blah. The objective of this session is blah, blah, blah. May I introduce our speaker today, Mr. Najamuddin. Present position. Mr. Najamuddin is a head of blah, blah, blah. He got his S1 degree in State University of Makassar. There will be time for a question after this presentation. Now, I'd like to invite Mr. and Mrs. to give the talk. Thank you, Mr. Najamuddin, for an interesting presentation. As I can see, there are blah, blah, blah main issues that can be raised in the presentation. First, taken finally. Now, it's time for question and discussion. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes this session. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a close to the speaker and the audience. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Ibu Mutmainah. Very good, Ibu Mutmainah Mursidin. Thank you very much. Applause to Ibu Mutmainah. Ibu Mala, do you have any comment on the materials that I gave you?
I think it's very great because a long time I didn't speak English. And then it is very useful for me to increase my English, especially because I didn't have place friends to speak English. And then I think this place is a very great to us to listening, to listen, and then to speak, to try to speak, to listen. And then after that, we will try to write. And that's the difficult skills, I think.
Ibu Mala, I think I have a very special appreciation to you because you are from Arabic, yeah? Arabic department,
yes,
right?
I am from Arabic department.
I think you are a very multilingual person. You are from Arabic major, but you speak English very well. I'm from the English department, but I don't know any of Arabic except the Arabic words for prayers, yeah? I know Allahu Akbar, I know Bismillah, I know a lot of things like that, but I don't know how to speak in daily conversation in Arabic. Very good, Ibu Mala. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you very much, ma'am, for your time to me to speak here. And then,
thank you
very much.
You're welcome. Okay, next, please. Can we give the chance to other participants to give comments or to speak up, to say everything about their experience or their expectation, or maybe to practice moderating, yes?
I want to ask something, if you don't mind.
Oh, Pak Adam, okay.
Yeah.
Please do, Pak Adam.
In the last session that you you asked to us to prepare be moderator, and all you right. ask as you maybe you ask to you can you say that you can we can to write the text maybe
the draft?
the draft. Is that a tip for us to improve our English practicing for becoming moderator so we can draft? But I thought that if we become a moderator, it's not good if we write from the draft for the conference or the event.
Yeah.
Is that a tip or yes?
Oh, well, actually, Pak Adam, you don't need to worry, because actually when we act as a moderator, we also bring a note, yeah, at least biodata of the speaker. So if you have like the pointers of what you are going to say, that is also good to save you, not to forget things to say, yeah. But you can also, if you are not confident enough with the points only or with your memory only, you can always bring your draft, as long as you still maintain eye contact with the audience. Jadi nggak apa-apa Pak Adam membawa draft juga, asal tetap ada eye contact. Jadi di rumah udah belajar dulu, terus nanti di dengan audience ada eye contact, membacanya tidak melulu melihat di kertas terus gitu ya. Jadi triknya dengan sering eye contact dengan audience, tapi sesekali cheating ya, sesekali apa sih, curang sedikit lah, menyontek gitu, menyontek dari draft nggak apa-apa, karena orang juga menyangka yang di draftnya yang dilihat itu biodata of speaker. Usually as a moderator we bring with us the piece of paper that contains the biodata of the speaker. Jadi nggak apa-apa kalau paling disangka juga kita bawa biodata of speaker gitu, asal kita jangan mata kita ke arah kertas terus gitu. So I think it's okay Pak Adam, but if you can memorize of course it's better. But if you cannot, you can always bring your draft. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
And Lucy, also, actually, when you, why I ask you to write a draft last week? Because actually, when you write handwriting, I think there is research saying that when you write, your mind also thinks. So it also store in your memory. Jadi kalau kita menulis, sebenarnya apa yang kita tulis itu lalu masuk ke pikiran gitu ya, jadi ke ingatan, masuk ke dalam ingatan, sehingga itu menjadi alat belajar yang efektif. So actually I did it with purpose. Kalau saya meminta Anda mengedraft menulis, sebenarnya itu with purpose ya, ada tujuannya, karena memang menurut penelitian kalau orang apa, orang menulis tangan, tulis tangan itu sebenarnya dia otaknya juga menginput pengetahuan yang dia tuliskan gitu. Jadi memasukkan ke dalam memori gitu. Jadi ada bagusnya mengedraft lalu nanti dilatihkan. But today I'm really happy to see a lot of very good speeches acting as moderators. What do you think Pak Adam?
Okay, Bu. Thank you, Bu, for the explanation.
But do you agree? Do you agree that bringing a draft is okay as long as your eye contact is still with the audience? Even in Bahasa Indonesia, Pak Adam, last time when I acted as a moderator with DMI, Dimensi Islam, I also drafted my speech as a moderator.
Yeah, as audience, when I saw the moderator that use note, I thought, is it okay? Is it okay, I think? Because but you have in the important thing that, what is that? Don't lose the eye contact, yeah.
Right,
I think that's
right.
The important thing.
Yeah, I agree, Pak Adam. Yeah.
Okay, but
It would be disturbing for the audience to look at the moderator looking down at the papers, you know, reading the papers, reading the notes, and not looking at the audience. So I think it's important that you maintain eye contact with your audience.
Okay, Bu Izzy, thank you, Bu.
Okay, you're welcome.
Yeah. Excuse me, Ibu Izzy.
Yes, Pak Hasbi. Yes, please.
2 hours ago, when I was joining the international webinar,
right?
I have one interesting phenomena. One of the speaker did not use English fully. but
all right,
he used about 80 to 90% of Indonesian. The strategy present his topic by using
PowerPoint.
The key. Yeah, mm-hmm. the point of his explanations, the key points, all in English. That's the emphasizing. Yeah? Yes, I noticed, I observed that, and in my mind, wow, this is a smart guy. Yeah.
It's a bit.
Yes. Smart. The key points all in English. So right. Yes.
The audience still okay. So the international audience still understand the key points, right? Because
yes,
it's written the there in the PowerPoint. But
good
then,
idea.
Yeah, it's a good idea for someone who is not very confident with all English speaking, yeah, with all English. Yes. But of course, it depends on the audience too. When majority of participants are Indonesian, that would be okay.
Yes.
But when majority are non-Indonesian, then that would sound, you know, that's a pity, you know, like that would not be appropriate. For example, you are presenting if you are presenting a paper, for example, in an English speaking country or maybe in a country where English is second language or where the participants are majorly from a countries other than Indonesia, then
yes,
that would not be appropriate. Yeah. But if majority of the participants are Indonesian.
Yes, I knew he can speak in English very well, but maybe that's a good idea for he or she who wants to, yeah, in my mind that's a good strategy for the people who want to speak English in conference or international webinar, but the ability of speaking still
limited.
Yeah, limited. That's so.
Yeah. I agree, Pak Hasbi. I would agree if majority of participants are Indonesian. But if majority are people from other countries, I would suggest that speaker use more English than Indonesian. Okay. Thank you, Pak Hasbi, by the way. Any other comments from other participants, perhaps? Greetings from Poso. Okay, that Ibu Marta.
Bu Isi, Bu Nur Zaida.
Oh, okay, Pak.
No, Bu Zaida wants
okay,
to say something.
I also I see. Okay. After Bu Nur Zaida, then we will let Pak Jimmy Kromiko. Yeah, there will be Pak Jimmy Kromiko is raising his hand. So after Ibu Nur Zaida, Pak Jimmy. Okay, Bu Nur Zaida.
Yeah, thank you, Bu Isi and Pak Arif and all the participants. I just want to say that I really appreciate the materials that Bu Isi has provided because. By reading the material, I can learn the structure of being a moderator, and then also the language appropriate use in chairing a session, and then I also want to appropriate this forum because I think. Most of the participants agree with me because by joining this forum, we have time to use our English. Like Pak Hasbi mentioned that we need to practice. So as teachers, especially junior high like me, junior high teachers, I don't have time. I mean, I don't have much chance to use my English. So I really appreciate the forum and also the materials that have been provided by in this forum.
Thank you, Ibu. Thank you for your appreciation. Thank you, Ibu. Now let's give the chance to Pak Jimmy. Pak Jimmy, are you going to practice your moderating the seminar or are you going to give comments? Please do.
Okay. Thank you for the times. In this presentation, I will give some kind of comment. Today, I will talk about the conversations, and then I will give some point conversations, especially about the speak itself. There are some point that we are really need to pay attention about how to speak up and how to speaking in front of the people or and everywhere and anywhere. The first one is we need to pay attention about the volume. The volume is our voice, whether our voice is audible for the audience or not. Yeah. Jadi ada berapa poin yang harus kita perhatikan ketika kita berbicara atau practice English. Yang pertama itu adalah volume, volume suara kita. Nah, apakah bisa terdengar oleh speaker, oleh audiens atau tidak? Nah, itu kita harus mengetahui sebagai as the speaker. Yeah, we need to know about that. How about our volume? Is it audible or not? Ya, kedengaran nggak atau nggak sama audiens? And then the second one, this is the clarity. Yeah. Clarity itu semacam like speak clearly and distinctly some of the time, but mispronounce. Kita ngomongnya lancar, tapi ada sebagian kosakata atau kata-kata yang kita mispronunciations. And then, poin berikutnya, itu adalah fluency. Nah, fluency ini practice so that all of us can speak English well. As long as we practice and practice. Kemudian, pace and flow. Nah, pace ini adalah pulse. Ketika kita berbicara itu ada jedanya, pulse. Apakah kita pulse-nya terlalu lama? Jika kita berbicara, when we speak English, the pause is too long, it will make the audience bored. And then, the second one is eye contact. Yeah. This is the most important thing that we should pay attention about our eye contact. Apakah eye contact kita itu sudah maintain ya some of the speak. Kemudian berikutnya postur kita, apakah poor postur ketika kita berbicara, apakah good postur. Kemudian enthusiasm. Nah, enthusiasm ini adalah bagaimana how the speaker, bagaimana kita si pembicara ini enthused during delivery demonstration of enthusiasm. Jadi bagaimana speaker itu memperlihatkan tingkat antusias dia dalam berbicara. Apakah dia benar-benar serius, benar-benar menguasai. Nah, itu terlihat daripada point enthusiasm. Kemudian, length of the speech. Ya, length ini durasi. Jadi ketika kita berpidato atau berbicara, length of the time itu perlu kita perhatikan. Ketika kita sebagai moderator, diberi waktu sekitar 5 menit, itu kita harus sesuaikan waktu yang diberi oleh panitia dengan yang kita ucapkan. Jangan sampai kita belum sampai kepada poin waktu sudah habis. Ya, jadi kita perlu perhatikan length of the speech. Kemudian memorizations. Nah, ini perlu sekali bagaimana how far we can memorize all our speech, dan itu perlu need much practice also ya. The last one, visual. Nah, visual itu kalau kita seperti kita webinar ini, bagaimana kita menggunakan share container screen itu sesuai tidak dengan apa yang kita sampaikan, antara topik dengan visual, gambar yang kita tampilkan itu sesuai atau tidak. Jadi itu sedikit masukan comment from me about speak ya, about conversation. Jadi ada beberapa poin yang perlu kita perhatikan. Volume kita, clarity, kemudian pace and flow, and then eye contact, and also posture, and then enthusiasm. Dan kesemua elemen itu, it will be it really important for us as the speaker. Yeah, I think that's all. Thank you for your time.
Thank you very much, Pak Jimmy. That was a very good feedback. Yes, I agree with you. Usually when I assess my students with their speaking performance, you know, when they do public speaking, I would use some rubrics, scoring rubrics. And in the scoring rubrics, there are some components. The first component is overall performance. Overall performance consists of, you know, things like posture, and then eye contact, and then volume, and then speed of speech, the speed of speech. But then also how they handle visual, like PowerPoint, if they use PowerPoint. And then another element is like the language use, the grammar or the appropriateness of expressions that they use. And then we also have pronunciation element, also fluency element, as you mentioned also. Thank you very much, Pak Jimmy. I agree with you that when we speak, to be a good performer of speaking, we need to consider all those things, because also as a teacher we have to assess those elements when students perform their speech. I agree with you, Pak Jimmy. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Okay. The chance to others, please. Any other participants to give comments or to practice? Okay, Bapak Misdi. Bapak Misdi, would you please would you please turn on your microphone?
Well, hello. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you everyone for inviting me for this today lovely discuss on this MC, Master Ceremony. This is my first experience using webinar in this case, and hopefully I can join further events so that I can improve my performance. And from the presentation of Ibu Prof. Isri, it is very interesting, and the comment from the friends also very enlightening, that it can was enrich my listening ability. Maybe I will contribute to the next sessions, because there is no well preparation for today.
Right.
But lovely Bu, thank you for the insightful of presentations. Love it very much, and greeting from Cirebon, Ibu ya.
Oh, from Cirebon. Thank you very much, Bapak Misdi.
Thank you.
Thank you for your appreciation and for your participation. Now, I think there is another person here, Ibu Siti Samadia. Please, Ibu, turn on your video and microphone.
So sorry, ma'am. Something happened, so I cannot on my video. But is it okay if I just use?
Yeah. Okay, you can use your audio.
Okay, yeah, may I the audio? I'll try to be the presenter, ma'am.
Okay, yeah, sure.
Okay. Aduh, malu.
It's okay.
Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Gentlemen, welcome to this session. Now we are going to listen to Mr. Ahmad to talk about blah blah blah. The objective of this session is blah blah blah. May I introduce our speaker today, Mr. Ahmad. Mr. Ahmad is the director of blah blah blah. Before that, Mr. Ahmad was at blah blah blah. Mr. Ahmad got his S1 degree in blah blah blah. There will be time for questions after presentation. Please address the questions to the chair. Mr. Ahmad will be happy to answer your questions. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, now I'd like to invite Mr. Ahmad to give the talk. Alhamdulillah, thank you. Thank you very much for Mr. Ahmad for your interesting presentation. And as I can see, there are four main issues that can be raised in the presentation. First, blah, blah, blah. Second, blah, blah, blah. And finally, blah, blah, blah. That would be all for the comments. Now, if you have any questions, now it's time for question Q&A session and discussions. If you have any questions, Mr. Ahmad will be happy to answer. And please raise your hand if you have questions. Can I call one question from the left of the room? Ah, yes, madam, please stand and tell your questions briefly. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes this session. And I would like to thank the speaker for a very informative talk. I'd also like to thank the audience for their participation. I wish to thank the speaker for an interesting presentation and the audience for a lively discussion. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give applause to the speaker and the audience. Let's show our appreciation to the speaker and audience. I think that's all for today. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Let's give applause to Ibu Siti Sumadia. I think it's time for feedback. Pak Arif and I will give feedback. And later, when we still have time before 1:30, we can also give the chance for comments from others. Now I will give the chance to Pak Arif to give the feedback. Please, Pak Arif.
Okay, thank you, Bu Isi. So I think that I'm very glad and I'm very happy today because many participants are actively participating in this webinars, and it is also not for a non-English subject, but for me as the English users, I'm very happy because today I'm also practicing my I think that this is based on my experience joining some seminars, and then in one hand there were many people or language users who used English, and they wanted to be native-like. Yeah, in this case, their English looked like British or Americans. But the problem is that many audience didn't understand what they're talking about. Yeah, because they use what we call it as very standard English. And then on the other experience, once I joined a conference and the speaker was from Hong Kong, and then he used the English by using a very unique accent. Yeah, for example, like a good morning, ha, right? Ha, how's not English? And then I think that this is something funny, right? Because even we are not native, but when we heard about good morning, ha, I think this is not a good English. And then my conclusion is that it's not a matter of whether our English is native-like or Indonesian-like, but we try to use a very communicative English. What is meant by communicative? Meaning that the speaker and listener can understand one another. Yeah, maybe this is my my conclusion. Yeah, so please for everyone here, keep practicing your English. You don't have to be native-like. And then, but at least your English can be understood by the audience. Yeah, maybe that's all from me, Bu Isi.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Arif. I agree with you 100%. We don't need to be native-like because we will never be native-like because our tongue, our mother tongue is already established. But the most important thing in the standard of in learning English, the current standard of learning English, the current level of achievement is not native-likeness anymore. So the idea is intelligibility, as long as, or communicability, as long as your English is communicable, as long as your English is intelligible, it is understood by people from other nations, then that is, that's it. Yeah, you don't need to be.
Okay, yes. Once more, Bu Isi, once more, Bu Isi.
Yes.
So
yes, please,
once I once I joined a conference, it was by Asia Tafel, yeah? And then
right?
even English in the Philippines is as the second language, but they don't speak English well. For example, like impossible, the people there said like impossible, right?
The Filipino dialect. Yeah. They would say, you know, the a, the English a. For example, to fax, they would say to fax, right? So the English a, like bad, they would say bad. You know, they say a.
Yeah,
you know, instead of a. Yeah.
They say impossible. What is impossible? Impossible or impossible, right?
Impossible, yes. That's dialect, Pak Arif. Yeah. And that's okay. Yeah, as long as people from other nation understand. We also I'm also the Tegal dialect. Also I have a very strong accent too. So if native English speakers listen to me, they would definitely notice that I'm not a native English speaker because I have a very strong accent, Indonesian accent, Tegal accent. Well, I will give feedback to from the speakers before. Like I will not mention names, but I will just give like general feedback. For example, some pronunciation feedback is like most Indonesian people would say method. It should be method, yeah. But it's okay because other people would understand. This is just for feedback. Yeah. For example, and then answer. Many Indonesian people say answer with the W, the W, the sound W there. Actually, the W is not pronounced. Answer, yeah. W-nya tidak perlu dibaca. And then I also noticed karena saya ada salah ketik, typo, there was a typo in my materials. Jadi ketika Anda mengatakan tadi, state your question briefly. Please state. Tapi karena ketikannya salah, stale, tadi mungkin ada yang mengucapkannya stale. Jadi itu salah ketik, harusnya state. Please state your question briefly. Kemudian, thank you. Banyak orang Indonesia tidak bisa mengucapkan bunyi ini. Thank you. Jadi orang Indonesia lalu banyak yang mengambil bunyi terdekatnya dengan T atau dengan S. Banyak yang mengatakannya dengan thank you atau thank you. Harusnya thank you. Ya. Birthday atau birthday. Harusnya birthday. Jadi memang itu sih perlu dilatih aja, tapi tidak masalah karena it's okay because people from other countries will understand you. Ya. Kemudian ada bahasa Inggris itu yang tulisannya AU ada yang dibaca O, O panjang. Misalnya audience. Jadi bukan audience membacanya, audience ya. Kemudian automatic ya, tidak automatic membacanya automatic ya. Audience automatic gitu ya. Kemudian tadi misalnya menyebut Profesor Hadi. Namanya misalnya Hadi Martono. Mestinya kalau kita pakai standar international kita pakainya Profesor Martono karena Martononya itu yang dianggap last name. Although in Indonesia most of Indonesian people don't use family name, ya. Yeah. Only people in only Batakis, ya. Yeah. Only people in North Sumatra and people in Maluku, people in Manado, maybe they have family name, but most Indonesian people don't have family name. So when we have international conference or meeting on or in our passport, usually they will consider the second name as the last name. Kalau kita nama kita terdiri dari dua, biasanya yang belakang itu yang dianggap sebagai last name, gitu ya. Jadi misalnya ada Hadi Martono, Professor Martono, something like that. Karena kalau sudah menyebut title, Professor, Doctor, Mister, Mrs. dan sebagainya, itu apa ya? Diucapkannya yang berikutnya setelah Mr. Professor itu biasanya last name-nya ya, Professor Martono, Mr. Trump, Mrs. Clinton gitu ya misalnya ya, semacam itu. Sama dengan kata applause. Applause juga ada tadi ya seperti audience lalu applause. Jadi bukan applause karena AU di sini dibaca O panjang. Oke, okay, applause, give applause ya. Kemudian, right. Semua tadi sudah dibicarakan oleh Pak Jimmy, hal-hal lain selain language, other than the language features, we also have to consider other things like the posture, the gesture, the eye contact, the volume, and so on, as mentioned by Pak Jimmy before. I think those are the feedback I give you. Now we still have 8 minutes. If anyone want to give comment or say anything, please raise your hand if you have any comments or anything to share. Anyone want to give comment? Maybe Ibu Ning, would you give additional feedback or comment, Ibu Ning?
Just one word probably, that only one word only, target. Mostly Indonesian men pronounce target.
Yes, agree Ibu Ning. Most of the time, Indonesian people say target. With, actually, it should be target, yeah, target. But orang Indonesia
seperti
orjen
tunggal ibu, like orjen tunggal.
Yeah, solo orjen. Indonesian people say solo orjen. Lotsin. Lebih organ, ya. Lalu magic jar, jar. It should be jar. Tidak semua a. Not all the alphabet A is said A. Tidak semua huruf A itu dalam bahasa Inggris dibaca A. Nah itu tidak konsistennya bahasa Inggris. Ada yang dibaca E, seperti bad, mad, ya, sad, tapi ada yang dibacanya A, misalnya father. Kan kita tidak membaca feather, right? Ada yang dibacanya A panjang, father. Demikian juga jar, tidak magic jar. Putus-putus ya? Jadi A tidak selalu dibaca E. Bisa juga dibaca A, long A. Misalnya, magic jar. Terus, father. Tidak feather. Tidak feather. Father. Can you still hear me?
Ya. Yeah. Kedengaran, Bu.
Jadi
ini Bu Isi juga, sering kalau kita mau buka komputer atau keluar dari Facebook atau keluar dari apps, itu kan ada kata log in dan log out. Orang Indonesia selalu bilangnya login.
Login, ya. Orang Indonesia menyangka huruf G, baca Inggris semuanya dibaca dengan J. Jadi ada target, ada origin, login. Ada login, ya.
Ada yang dia login. Guru bahasa Inggris bilang language. Aduh, kasihan.
language, ya. Jadi itu, but that that is understandable, Buning, because English spelling is not consistent like Indonesian. Bahasa Indonesia itu konsisten. A ya dibaca A dimanapun huruf itu muncul. U ya dibaca U dimanapun huruf itu muncul. But English spelling is not consistent. For example, G. G itu tidak semuanya dibaca dengan J, ya. Jadi ada tadi kayak login, harus log. Kan tidak menjadi lodge. Tapi kan di tempat lain, G itu dibaca dengan J, ya enggak? G, ya enggak?
Ya,
yeah, giant misalnya. Giant
it's
kan dibacanya enggak?
Teacher of English.
Ya, yeah. Teachers of English should be familiar with you know, yeah, this inconsistency of spelling. Jadi demikian juga vowel, ya. Demikian juga vowel, bukan hanya konsonannya bahasa Inggris yang tidak konsisten, tetapi vowel. Vowel itu seperti tadi, ya, ada AU yang dibaca O, authentic. Ada tulisan EA, mostly EA is pronounced E. Semua yang tulisan bahasa Inggris kebanyakan itu dibaca E. Misalnya speak, neat, clean. Ya. Kebanyakan kan EA itu dibaca E. But that's not all. Tidak semua. Not all EA is pronounced E. Tidak semua yang ditulis EA itu otomatis bacaannya E. Ada EA yang dibacaannya A, EI dibacanya. Misalnya great, great. We don't say great, we say great. You look great today. Ya, jadi EA dibaca EI. Kemudian ada juga EA dibaca, contoh lain EA dibaca E misalnya break. We need a break. Kita butuh break, kita butuh istirahat. Ya kan? Tidak, yeah, tidak break. Bukan brick, membacanya bukan brick. Demikian juga steak. Makanya ada warung namanya Steak and Shake. Warung itu ada slogannya steak and ada apa menunya tuh steak and shake. Itu bunyinya rhyme, ya, bunyinya rhyming. Steak and shake. Jadi bukan steak and shake. Karena itu membacanya EI, steak. Ya, jadi steak and shake. Kemudian EA juga ada yang dibaca lain, ya, selain dibaca I, dibaca EI, ya.
Dan made.
Ya, demikian juga
made
CH,
you,
ya.
Made you.
Ya. Ya, betul Bening. Demikian juga CH, ya. CH itu tidak semua dibaca CH. Mostly dibaca CH, misalnya chair. This is my chair. Tetapi CH ada yang dibaca K. Misalnya chemistry, chemical, architecture. Tidak architecture. Dibaca K. Tapi CH juga ada yang dibaca sheh. Ada yang dibaca sheh, ya. Misalnya chef. Chef. Bukan dibaca chef. Yang koki itu, ya. Koki masakan itu, ya.
Master.
Ya. Jadi we say chef, not chef. Ya. We say chic, not chic. Ya. Jadi kalau
busy,
orang yang
dandanannya busy.
Busy, not busy. Nah, itu dia. Huruf U tidak semuanya dibaca A karena tulisannya busy kita bacanya busy, ya enggak, tulisannya U padahal di tempat lain huruf U dibaca A. So that those are the examples of inconsistency between spelling and pronunciation in English. English spelling is very much inconsistent, so that's why it's really hard for English learners, yeah, if they generalize, if they over generalize sounds. Kalau mereka lalu meng-over generalize, semua IEA mesti dibaca I, semua ini double O dibaca U, ya pasti nanti ada ketemu saat di mana salah. Because not all double O is pronounced U. Double O kebanyakan memang dibaca U, misalnya good, food,
cool,
cook, dan sebagainya. Cool, ya. Yeah. Buning, good. Tetapi ada yang tidak dibaca U. ada yang dibaca A, misalnya blood, flood, dan sebagainya. Tapi ya ada juga yang dibacanya O, misalnya door, floor. Jadi kita membacanya door, floor, bukan dur, floor. Karena kalau dur, floor, jadi nanti dibacanya lagu itu ada lagu yang bunyinya there is a window, there is a door, there is the blackboard, this is the floor. Nanti jadi dinyanyikannya there is the window, there is the door, there is the blackboard, this is the floor. Ini kan jadi seperti itu ya lagunya gitu. Jadi not all the we cannot overgeneralize pronunciation in English because you know spelling and pronunciation in English are a bit inconsistent, yeah. Unlike Indonesian, Indonesian is very consistent, yeah. So it's very easy for non-Indonesian to learn Indonesian sounds, yeah, because the spelling and the sounds are always consistent. Any comment? Any other comment?
A question from me. So, what is the topic for next week?
Well, our course is actually for everyday conversation, but because of the request for a presentation in a seminar last week and today, we have this role as the moderator. Next week, I will give you how to give a presentation in a seminar or conference, and then the next week is for practicing. To be a presenter in a seminar, although the content can be skipped, like pre-memory, something like that, yeah. So, but the language you use to introduce and so on before presentation, I will give you next week. And then after the 2 weeks of giving presentation, we will get back to everyday conversation.
And also, I think I have an idea about how to conducting the discussion, mm-hmm. how to interrupt, and how the what is it, the kind of expression for this session.
Oh yeah. Okay, Ibu.
Very maybe, important, we see.
Yes. Okay, that would be a good idea. That would be in one of our session. Yeah. And to the newcomers, I should tell you that the certificate of your participation will only be given after some sessions, yeah. After some sessions are completed. Jadi nanti setelah beberapa sesi, sesi kita, sesi training kita, setelah sekian sesi baru nanti akan diberikan sertifikat. Not every session, tidak setiap sesi. Jadi nanti kalau ikut terus sampai berapa sesi, mungkin 4 atau 6 sesi lagi kita akan beri.
Why not sorry?
Okay, any other comments or question? Please okay. Raise your hand.
May I, Zaidi?
Yes, please do.
Yeah.
Nur Zaida.
Okay, Ibu.
Yeah. The talk, thank you for the feedback and the talk about addressing people. I think it's very interesting, interesting topic because this is very culturally bound, I think. It happened to me actually when I was in Bangkok having joining a seminar and becoming one of the presenters there. And then someone, the committee probably kept calling me Dr. Zaida, and I didn't respond it because I was not used to be called the surname, yeah, or the family name.
You think it's someone else, not your
yes,
name?
indeed, yeah. And then also
because you expect people to call you Dr. Nur, right?
Yes. Or Ida. Usually.
You expect people to call you Dr. Nur or Dr. Ida instead of Dr. Zaida, right?
Yes, that's true. And another one happened here. A friend of there is a friend here. Then coming from Irish, he is an Irish, and then his name is William something, William C. Loffitt, yeah. So the surname is Loffitt, but he said that call me William, but it's very awkward to just call him William because he is much older than us, so people call him Mr. William. And then I said, if you want to call Mr., use the family name, but it's, I know it's hard, and to me it's hard to call him just the name because of the age. And I think it's, as I mentioned, this is very culturally bound. So yeah, this is very interesting things that our students should know. Yeah, thank you, Bu Isi, for the feedback.
Yes. Yes, I agree with you, Ibu Nur Zaida. So I think we should, as a teacher or as a lecturer of English, we should give cultural convention. Yeah, like what is like international tradition also. What is traditionally natural in an international encounter for addressing people and for other things. Yeah, I think we should give like cultural understanding to the students, not only learning the linguistic form, but also to learn the culture. I agree with Ibu. Next, I think we have here Ibu Sumarni. Ibu Sumarni is raising hand. So Ibu Sumarni, yes. Would you please say what you want to say?
Yes, Bu Isi. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Nice to be here to see you all. Yeah. I would like to say that beside the pronunciation, that mostly people make mistake, also about the grammar. I found that many participants in international. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Now okay. It's okay.
All right. Some people say like I'm understand, I'm agree. You know, or I'm like, so it's just like, it is very common. I think you also experience that, Buisi. Do you?
Yes, yes. I experienced that with my students and also, with a lot of English participants. So I think I always give as a basic knowledge of English sentence is to distinguish between nominal sentence and verbal sentence. That is very important. For teachers of English, it is very important to give as a basic knowledge of grammar to give the students the distinction between verbal sentence and nominal sentence, so they will not mix up to give like to be in, you know, in things like this. I understood it should be a subject and a verb, but then they put to be. That to me is only in a nominal sentence, like in this case. So it is very important for teachers to distinguish between nominal sentence and verbal sentence, to give that to the students. So then they will not get confused where to put to be and where not to put to be.
Even some for English.
I agree with that, Bu Marti.
Yeah, sometimes it's quite difficult to change the way you say.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, like obeying fossilized.
Yeah, I agree.
And other thing about what Pa Adam say about being not natural to see drop, it will be all right because it is very natural to see, you know, a paper as long as we make it natural, not only stick on that point.
To see a note.
And
yeah.
I think, note. And I think when we are in that context, naturally we will get used to the situation. So don't worry about that. It will be okay. You know, maybe before we did it, we will think, oh, it will be like this. It will be not natural. But once you are in that situation in international conference, you all those worries will disappear because you will see, we all see that many other participants also have very strong action. Also, sometimes even we don't get the point what they say, but they are more confident, like, you know, particularly for a participant from Philippines, for example, or India, they have strong accent also.
Yeah.
We all have our accent. Even I don't know what accent I have.
Yeah.
Okay, I think that's all. We see.
Indonesian accent, Ibu Marni.
Thank you.
Okay, we have 1 minute. Ibu Fitri, maybe you have something to say, Ibu Fitri, the moderator.
Yep. Thank you, Bu Izzy. I'm afraid that time is up. And I think it is very interesting for the topic for today's sessions. There are so many listen today that all the participants looks like very enthusiastic to practice. And there are so many information, or there are so many lessons from you, from Pak Arif, and a lot of advice and a lot of comment from the participant also makes us maybe more confidence to be a moderator or to be a chairman in a seminar, and very, very valuable for me. There's so many new knowledge, new lesson for me. And maybe for the next session, Bu Izzy will remind us to be more brave, to try and to practice in everyday conversation or in a formal situation like that, Bu Izzy.
Yeah.
That's my comment.
Thank you, Ibu Fitri. Very valuable comments. And Pak Adam, I also need to remind everyone here to subscribe DMI channel, DMI YouTube channel. Because from the DMI YouTube channel, you can also see our previous English encounter, our previous English forum like this. Yang belum ikut minggu sebelumnya, bisa cek course kita sebelumnya di channel DMI, and Pak Adam, I think Pak Adam has put the link of the DMI YouTube channel on the chat box, and Pak Adam will also share with you the draft of chairing a session that I have provided before, so it will be there. Pak Adam, please share the draft moderating or chairing a seminar. Time is up, I think. So, Ibu moderator, Ibu Fitri.
Thank you again. Once more again, that I want to thanks to Bu Izzy, Pak Arif, and all of the participants that joined this program this afternoon. And apologize about my weaknesses to moderate this session. And thanks, and would like to see you next week. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Pak Arif, maybe Pak Arif, you want to say something, Pak Arif?
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Pak Arif? Okay.